Hello, my dear students. I would like to welcome you all to my English class today. Today we are going to learn a new unit. The unit name is Human Rights. All right. So, what are human rights exactly? What really matters with our English, right? Human rights. When we term this word, actually, somewhere we could have already heard about. These kind of rights possessed by human beings on this earth, a particular nation, or maybe a particular region, or maybe a particular state. All right. So, what human rights are directly subjected into social, right? But now, today, we are not at all talking about human rights topic, but our unit name is Human Rights. Today, we are going to learn a lesson. As an AVB, which is called as Jamaican fragment. You might have already heard my experience. Jamaica is one of the countries of the world. And you know what? Jamaica is Black people's nation. You know Usain Bolt, the fastest runner of the world. Is from the same country, Jamaica. All right. So, what actually, this is all introduction which I would like to take you through. Jamaica is a country of black people, okay? Black people in the sense, they are not white, especially from African continent or maybe some parts of America wherein we have black race and white race, right? So today we are going to discuss a lesson which is really, really interesting. And you know what? The narrator of our A reading, Jamaican fragment. What is fragment? Fragment is a piece or a part of something. A piece or part of something. So Jamaican fragment in the sense, a piece or part of Jamaican nation. Let us see. Okay. So, my dear students, I would like to share it like a story. All right. So, actually, when we go into the content, L. Hendricks is our narrator. He is a black man who specifically belongs to Jamaica. He's a true Jamaican. L. Hendricks. He writes this story, which he has noticed on a particular day when he was going to the workplace. The workplace is called Tata Lines, where he works. So every day, our narrator rides from his home to the Tata Lines. It might be like 1.5 miles. 1.5 miles. Every day he goes by walk on foot. And you know what? Our narrator feels so pleasant. Every day he feels so pleasant, you know? On the road on which our narrator walks to his working place, either side of that road is flanked by beautiful red colored bungalows, beautiful gardens, cottages kind of homes. Like, you know, you can, when someone looks at that site, wow factor, there is a wow factor in that particular area when we really walk. Such kind of a walk he enjoys. Who enjoys? Our narrator. Every day he goes to his work. Okay, from his home to the tram car lines where he decides on where he works. So, while walking, he really enjoys that. He really cherishes. He feels so pleasant. Not because of the walk or exercise. It's really good exercise, according to him. But still, he feels so delighted looking at the beautiful bungalows, beautiful gardens, and are really flanked by red and green colored roofs. You know what? It's such a wonderful scenery. You understood? So one day, what happened? Casually, on his way to his work, he noticed two boys. How many boys? Two boys. These two boys were playing right in front of a cottage, kind of home or a bungalow, where that is kind of in a garden, right in front of his home. Okay, and you know what? He felt so good looking at the two kids. They were playing interestingly, and you know what? Our narrator might have got some really time, and he went there, stood at the gate, and he was wondering, like, what is the game really exactly? What they are playing there? It is not so elaborate. He couldn't understand the game particularly on that very specific side, but still he manages himself trying to understand what is that particular game he is playing there. They are playing, the two boys. Let me describe in the words of the narrator how the two boys are. The first boy, they were little more than just babies. One might be 5 years old. Okay, one might be 5 years old. The other must be 4 years old. Just little bigger than the babies. You understood what I'm saying? Just bigger than the babies. Like 5 years old, one kid, the other kid is 4 years old. So when it comes to the 5 years old kid, you know what? This boy is dark skinned. What is the color of his skin? He is like dark, or you can say like black. Okay? The skin color is black or dark, we can say. And you know what, my dear students? After this, how his hair are exactly? You know, matte, of course, rigid, fluffy, like, you know, at our homes, particularly if I say, our hair are really, Indian's hair are mostly it is silky, or maybe like, you know, it dances according to the waves or like air, like the pressure of the air, our hair little dances or shakes or like, okay, it happens, like it is silky hair. But this boy's hair is different. It is rigid. Like, you know, mat at our doorstep in our homes, in order to get rid of the dirt which is sticking to our chappals or maybe shoes, we often have a clean washed doormat. So that doormat has some hair. It's like mat, of course, like, and this boy's hair is like such a rigid, strong. In Telugu, if you ask me particularly, I can say like guburga, gubur guburga. Okay, you understood? So the hair is like, you know, mat, of course, hair. How is his hair? Mat of hairs, and his skin is dark or black. All right? And you know what? His eyes are coal black. Coal black eyes. His eyes are coal black eyes. You know what, my dear students? Not only this, if I wanted to say, this boy is sturdy. Sturdy in the sense, strong body. Solid figure. He's not lean. He's not thin. He's not like, you know, fat. He's strong, rigid personality. Like such a good frame he has. Like, how is this 5 years old boy is described? His skin tone is particularly black with the matte folds of hair, and also he possesses coal black eyes. Coal black eyes. So he must be like our looking at that boy. Our narrator thought that he might be the Jamaica because he's dark-skinned and his hair is also matte, of course, like, and also particularly he is turning. Definitely this boy must be a Jamaican. Then what about this 4 years boy? This 4 years boy is fair in color, fair or white, we can say. Okay, and his hair is reddish brown. Reddish brown. His eyes. White or fair color. Next, his hair is reddish or brown. Hair. All right. Then how is his eyes? Eyes are like hazel eyes. You know what is the meaning of hazel? H-A-Z-E-L. What is the meaning of that? The meaning of that is his eyes are bluish, blue and the greenish color. Like he is like not like a Jamaican. Exactly. He's not at all like a Jamaican. He resembles an Englishman. This boy is like an Englishman. He's not a Negro. Neither is a black boy. His hair is absolutely reddish and brown as the white people. And his skin is white toned. And when it comes to his eyes also, bluish green. You understand what I'm saying? Students, so he's a black boy, he's a white boy. You got the point? But this 4 years old boy is also sturdy. But he is little smaller than that of the 5 years old black boy. But they were playing. Both were playing in that lawn, particularly not noticing our narrator. You know what? What might be the game? First, this white boy who is little smaller than the black boy. He is striding imperiously. He is striding imperiously. Like, you know, the march past which we see, the soldiers, the army people, not particularly 15th August in our country parade, they will be like imperiously with the proud of sense in his face. This boy is also like striding and he is passing orders to the black boy. Hey, go and get me some water. Then immediately the dark boy ran into the home, got the water. Hey yo, jump into the flowers. Then this boy jumped into the flowers of plants. You know what? Give me the stick. Immediately this black boy, whatever, this white small boy is ordered. This 5 years old big boy, who is a black, taking orders from him. This man is giving orders and that boy is taking the orders there. By looking at that side, the narrator, at once he astonished. He fell in puzzle. He got confused. Oh my God, what is going? Am I really watching the scene which I really noticing now? Such a small white boy is dominating the black boy. You got my point? Narrator is hallucinating himself looking at that. Two kids, even that small white boy, he's treating the black boy who is little bigger, even though treating as a slave. And also, look, the black boy, even the black boy is doing the same whatever commanded by this small white boy. Oh my God. What is going in my country, Jamaica? Is it true? Still this slavery is going on. These white people are dominating our black people, even as such small kids. I don't believe this shit. What is this? What is the kind of discrimination that can see within these two kids? Even this black boy, he knows right from his birth that he is meant to enslave himself to the white. And this white boy is not just a boy, he's just a baby. So he knows that he is growing to rule or dominate over the blacks. Is that really that gene is in the blood of the white people? And they are masters and these are slaves? Shut. I don't believe this. I have a guess now. Definitely these two, the black boy must be the son of the servant and the white boy must be the son of the owner. Okay, if it is so, let me think in the same sense. But they both are in the same color dress, blue shirts, khaki pants. Blue shirt and khaki pant. Both wear the same. If they are the sons of different people, if the servant, how can a servant and a master can wear the same dresses? No. I understood. One more guess as a narrator. This white boy must be the neighbor of the black boy. That's all. Finalized. But still, I couldn't digest the sight of discrimination being noticed within these small kids. So in that way, he went to his workplace. And all the day he was thinking about this. He totally fell in puzzle. Confusion. He couldn't digest that discrimination act which he saw there. In the evening after the work, he came there. The two boys were not there in the garden. And then his curiosity has raised to the heights of culmination. Like, you know, he felt so low. He felt so disturbed. Even in my country, our Jamaica is a country of blacks. Still this white domination is going on. Oh my God. He worried a lot for the whole night. The whole night he had worried the same. And what happened, you know, my dear students? He couldn't sleep the night because of that discrimination. Next day, in the morning, he was very curious to see that two boys. Went there in the same place and again he stood at the gate and he watched the two boys. They were playing in the garden, same as they played. The same game they were playing. But today it is a contrary. Today what happened, you know, my dear students? Today the black boy became the master. And the white boy is on the beck and call of the black boy. Black boy stood imperiously and he was ordering the white boy. Today, who is ordering whom? The next day, the black boy is ordering the white boy. Now, you know what? The white boy went into the home and got the banana. And peel the banana off and give it to me. Then immediately he peeled off the banana. And you know what? He ate it. Now go and get some water for me. Who ordered? The black boy ordered. The white boy jumped into the home and you know what? He got some water to drink. And the white boy followed the same instructions given by the black boy. By this, now narrator's heart was in a normal state. It became normal state. Now he felt so happy. Oh my God, now I understood. This was a game. When I was a kid, I used to play the same game. This game name is boss and servant, master and slave. Today, I have to be master and my friend has to be a servant. Next day, my friend has to be a master and I need to be a servant. Oh my God, I played this game. Unnecessarily, I worried. Unnecessarily, my thoughts really, oh my God. I wasted my whole night thinking about the nations and my people. Really, I hallucinated much. It's not at all particularly important. Anyways, I understood that this is a gift. Okay, fine. Now I am really completely got relaxed. But at the same time, on the either side of the same garden, there stood a white man. He was watching the same game which these boys are playing. Immediately, our narrator, he thought that he got an idea. Yes, that white man must be watching and thinking like me, as I thought yesterday. He must be worried today. He must be disturbed. He must be puzzled. You know what? Because the blacks are dominating on the white, right? He might be thinking that blacks are going to be the masters in the future and the whites going to be slave. He must be definitely worried about what is going on in the garden by looking at these two boys. But poor white man, why I have to leave it? I'll do one thing. I'll go talk to him and I will get rid of his confusion because unnecessarily I got disturbed. I will save that man from the disturbance and the confusion. Anyhow, tomorrow or the other day, he will understand. This is after all a game. Then he went there. Our narrator went, like, you know, he has this sign of proudness in his pride in his face. Hello, sir. Excuse me. Yeah, good morning. Good morning. I know what you are thinking. What? This white man was. But sir, what do you mean? What am I thinking? You are looking at the boys, right? Yeah, absolutely right. I am looking at the boys. Then you were also worrying that this white boy is being enslaved by the black and the black is giving order to the white. And you were thinking that blacks are going to dominate over the whites in Jamaica. That's what now you are thinking. Then, white man. What are you talking about? I'm not thinking. You know what? I have nothing thought about such a thing. No, sir. Yesterday even I also thought in that way. I thought yesterday this black boy was enslaved by this white boy. And this white boy dominated. You don't worry. This is like a boss and servant game. It's like a master and slave game, which I used to be playing. We used to play it in our childhood. Okay? You don't worry. Oh, sir, can you please stop what you are talking? Actually, I'm not worrying looking at my boys. I do a kind information. Hello, sir. I am the father of the two boys. Those two boys are my kids, my sons, my blood. Why I worry about the discrimination? Do you understand here? Immediately, a woman who is black, handsome woman with sturdy personality, she came out of the house and she shouted like, boys, come for the lunch. It's the time for us to eat together. And you know what, sir? She's my woman. She's my woman in the sense, she's my wife. And these two are my kids. And you know what? Whatever you are saying is nothing happened. They are both my boys and I know that is a game. The narrator, well in dynamite. Oh my God. I thought in such particularly curiosity. In a curiosity, I unnecessarily talked to that man actually. that man is a white man who married to a Jamaican black woman. So they got two kids. One is like English man, the other is a Jamaican woman. So these two boys are the kids of the white man who got married to the black Jamaican. So this is the story, students. Actually, racial discrimination was the factor. You know what? Under this human right, you know, what I would like to tell you is, like most of the countries, like we didn't see that most of the thing. Untouchability is one of the social issues which were faced by like some decades ago in India. Untouchability was something was there. But in America and many other countries, you know, what was the discrimination, you know, racial discrimination. Whites used to dominate over the blacks. Once, you know, Mahatma Gandhi also, when he traveled in South Africa, he was pushed out of the train as he was not a white man. Though he was a lawyer, like, you know, though he was an attorney general, like, you know, we can say prosecutor. But still he was thrown, pushed out of the train because he must not be allowed to travel in the first class compartment. These people, the blacks or the non-whites, must travel in the third class. You understood? Such kind of discrimination be like, you know, faced by so many people. So, but Martin Luther King, you know, the great man who received Nobel Prize, south of Nelson Mandela, Mahatma Gandhi, these all great people, they worked very hard and then, you know, they fought against such kind of social issues. And you know, under human rights, you can claim that. Now, what we have to do with this? Sir, why is human rights is parted with our language? Yeah, such kind of things also being notable, my dear students. Racial discrimination used to be some decades ago prevailed. But nowadays, all are equal. You know, Obama, the black, and became the president of India, and most of the things were changed, and you know, there is no racial discrimination these days. But I hope you must have enjoyed this lesson and got some particular knowledge, and I wanted you guys, this reading comprehension from this lesson is particularly very, very important for your annual examination. Okay, thank you very much, students. Thank you for this wonderful class. I hope you must have understood that. Right?